Hi dear students, welcome to NSME Learning. Today's topic of discussion is O Captain, My Captain, a famous American poem by the famous American poet Walt Whitman. This is a part of American literature which is prescribed for the fourth semester English honor students in C10 American literature. So dear students, in a series of videos, we shall be discussing the life, important works and events of the poet. Then we shall be talking about the background of the poem. Next we shall be talking about the title of the poem, and then we shall move on to the text. We shall go through the text line by line, word by word, with explanation, and finally we shall be talking about the probable and important questions from this topic. O Captain, My Captain was written in 1865, and it was published in the same year in Whitman's famous celebrated collection of poems, The Leaves of Grass, which is considered to be the milestone of American poetry. Before we move on to the background, I think we must have a clear conception about the poet, his life, important works and events. So Walt Whitman is called he is called a modern poet, the national poet of America, the democratic poet of America, as well as the father of free verse. It is not for nothing that he has been titled with so many titles. Actually, he is a genius who has reflected his talent everywhere in the field of literature. Again, he was a teacher, a journalist, an essayist. Even he worked as a male nurse in the Great American Civil War. He was born on 31st May in 1819 in Long Island, New York. Then in his childhood, he moves to Brooklyn. There he came under the influence of the Quakers. Now dear students, I would like to here pause for a few moments, because the question may come in your mind: who are the Quakers? Why are they called so? And what is the relevance of the Quakers in the writing of Walt Whitman? So I would like to tell you here that the Quakers are a group of people who believe that there is a very, very intimate and very, very personal relation, deep relation, intimate relation with God. That is human relation. Quakers believe that human relation to God or with God is purely a personal relation. So their belief, their thought about God differs from the thinking or the belief of idea of the worshippers, the prophets, the priests, the bishops, the archbishops. Of course, the Quakers believe in a different way. Quakers also believe in the simple living of human being, simple living of man. All right, now why are they called Quakers? When these people, these group of believers, when they are in a state of prayer, that is when they are devotionally performing their prayer, they tremble. Actually, they got into a trance-like condition, in a blessed condition, and in that trance-like condition they begin to tremble, they begin to quake. This is why they are called Quakers. Now what is the relevance of Whitman's belief in the Quakers, or what may be the relevance of this belief in his writing? Of course, one more thing, that the Quakers also believe in the equality of all human beings. They believe, strongly believe, that all human beings are born equal. So they want to give all human beings, they think actually that their opinion is that all human beings should be given equal opportunity, equal chances and equal facilities. That is, they were the singer of the equality, fraternity and freedom. Of course, In the writings of Walt Whitman, we would see that in the poems that are enlisted in his collection of poems, Leaves of Grass, he will speak of the American democracy. He will speak of the equality of all Americans. So there is the relevance of the close relation of Quakers and our poet Walt Whitman. Whitman started his career as a teacher, but soon he became a journalist. This is a very important factor. Why? Because this profession is a very significant part of Whitman's life. While he was working as a journalist, he has got the very, very strong opportunity, very, very positive opportunity to come in close contact with the American people, to see and judge the American people, American lives from a very, very close distance. That is why, and this experience that he gathered from his profession of journalism, from his close contact with God, this we see that he reflected later on in his writing, especially, particularly in his poems, which are published in his collection of poems, The Leaves of Grass. As a journalist, he launched his first journal, The Long Islanders, in 1839. And I told you that he was also a novelist. So then he published his novel, Franklin Evans, in 1842. Then he did his most important thing. What? In 1855, Whitman published his first edition of the great collection of poems, The Leaves of Grass. One thing I would like to tell you here, when The Leaves of Grass was published with its first edition, there were only 12 poems, and the total number of pages in the book were only 95. But when it was published with the final edition in 1891, with its ninth edition, the final edition, which is called the Deathbed Edition, there we see more than 400 poems were included in this great collection of poems. And this celebrated collection of poems, The Leaves of Grass, has a very, very significant bearing in the American literature in general and in American poetry in particular. Another important event of his life is when the Civil War broke out in America, which was started in 1861, continued till 1865. In that great Civil War, Whitman worked as a male nurse to care for Union soldier. And this also gave him a very, very great opportunity to have a very practical experience of American lives from a close distance. This experience that he gathered from this profession of a nurse, when he got the opportunity to see the American people from a close distance, then all his experience that he gathered from the battlefield, he reflected it in his another collection of poems called Drum Taps, where the poems, which collection contained poems related to Great American Civil War. Then next, in 1870, he published his Democratic Vistas to share his true democratic ideas, the ideas of American democracy. In the year 1882, he published the seventh edition of the leaves of grass. Now, one thing I must tell you here, that this edition was banned. Why? Because the critics then thought that Whitman's this edition contained poems which can be called obscene. Because of the obscenity, this edition, that is the 7th edition, was then banned. Why they consider the works of or the poems of this edition to be the obscene? Because here Whitman actually spoke of the open sexuality, and he celebrated human body, he celebrated human male body, he celebrated human female body. He also spoke of sexuality between men and women. Not only, even he spoke of the sexuality between men and men. So these were the things which were not accepted by the Americans. Why? Because the Puritan set of mind was not ready to see the things in the way Whitman presented. All right. Finally, in 1891, Whitman published the final edition, 9th edition, which is called the Deathbed Edition of the Leaves of Grass. And then he expired in 1892. So this is all about the life, significant works and events of the poet Walt Whitman. Now let's move on to the kind of the poem or the type of the poem. Oh Captain, My Captain, what kind of poem is this? So this poem, you know, in English literature there are many types of poem. Few poems are called sonnets, lyrics, odes, epics, elegies, and so on and so forth. So one of the kind is an elegy, and this poem, Oh Captain, My Captain, is categorized in the category of an elegy. Now, what is an elegy? You must know that. An elegy is a sad poem, usually written to mourn or express sorrow for the man or for someone who is dead. I repeat, an elegy is a sad poem, usually written to praise or express sorrow for someone who is dead, who is no more. Or it may sometime dealing with some great loss. It may be a national loss, it may be or any kind of other loss. That means it must be related to some sad incident, to some sad event. Now the question comes to our mind, as this poem is called an elegy, what is the reason behind? What is the sad incident for which the poem is called an elegy? To know that, we must know the background of the poem. So, of course, we shall be talking about the background of the poem in the next video. In this video, I want to end it here. Stay at home.